Hello and welcome to another episode of One Device, Two Enemies. This time, not with Jan and Tizian, but with the game designers of the game. Yeah, I'm Florian, and this is...
Johnny.
Yeah. So, we two worked on Deadly Desert together, and this time we decided to do the Deadly Desert game because it's a new game, and it was also a little bit unfair to Johnny if I play Frozen with him because I met Frozen and he didn't.
Yeah.
And yeah, I don't want to give I don't want to give myself that much of an advantage because you know I'm skilled and I don't need that. So yeah, I guess we will improvise a lot on the strategy side.
So
we just start. So let's go into pass and play. Which map do we take?
Battleground.
You did the battleground maps. I want one of my maps.
Yeah.
I like this one. The strong point standoff. Mm. It is necessary to occupy an old base. Both factions prepare to advance. Who can secure the strong point? So let's do that. Gold. Much gold.
Gold. Yeah, that's okay.
Yeah. We don't want to take too much time. So yeah. You want to start?
Yeah.
You start.
I take the adventure shots.
So I think from design side, I at least worked on all four titles, and it was always a little bit of a new challenge to get the user feedback and then put it into the game and make additions and maybe even some changes that were not that welcome or not that liked in the previous games. Like one example was camouflage. Yeah. So at the beginning, only camouflage was possible without moving, and then I thought, how could I improve that? And we added the moving while camouflaged, and I think that really did a lot to the feature. And it's interesting to see the progress that we made throughout the games, and yeah, see how it basically evolved into the deadly that it is now, and just seeing it in the user ratings and then the store is also deadly is the most liked game, so I guess we did something right with it, and that made me really happy. So thank you all for playing and rating the game very, very good.
Yeah, thank you guys.
Do your worst.
My turn now.
Okay. The problem was also when I played my. I flipped my maps and I moved the exact same way that I designed it, and then I always move into my mines and into my traps, and I'm like, oh my god, so dumb. And then I give it to testing, and testing never moved into the mines, and I'm like, how can you not move into those mines? Because I move it at very specific points, and that's where I place basically my maps, my mines. So,
yeah. Oh, wait.
I haven't seen any.
Yeah. You better not.
So Johnny, how do you come up with campaign concepts?
How do I come up with my concepts for the campaigns? I think it's just what I just said, that I first do some brainstorming and think about, okay, what could be the general idea of a campaign? Like for the campaign I did for Deadly Desert was the second of the Allies one, where you have to free your prisoner dudes in the jail. Yes, and this was just the first thought of okay, we have to storm a prison and get our comrades back. And then from that point starting, I had to think reversely, like this is my main goal and how do I get to this point, and so I have to do some reverse engineering, like for example, and think about okay, what will be on the way to the prison and what might happen during this journey through the first and the second mission to get to the actual prison. And yeah, then if I have a general idea about what the single missions will be about, I will think about some mechanics I want to have in the map so that it feels like something special. Like, I don't know, I think for the first mission of the second campaign, I tried to implement the mortar units into this game and work with the smoke screen, because I thought it was a really cool feature and it might not be used that much, because I don't know, maybe it's not just that effective because it's not doing damage to the enemy units, but instead it just takes the sight.
I tapped the second time.
Oh, okay. What the hell happened? No, what are you doing? How dare you?
Suddenly, F strike.
Yeah. Suddenly, F strike.
An example for my map design was, especially for Frozen, where we have a lot of campaigns already. I had sometimes the problem that I'm thinking, like, how could I make a new campaign interesting? Because I don't want to make like the same campaign that we had and just put another cool building in there. So one specific example that I had was with the mineshafts that we had in there, which was, I think, the sixth German campaign, I'm not sure. And that was just, how could I make a cool gameplay feature which doesn't require too much effort to put into, because we can't develop new games and also take like months to make a new campaign. So I thought to myself, what would be nice in there, what could be used in there, and then I found a lot of, I mean, research stuff, or not really research, just papers online, which were basically, and there was a lot of mine stuff in there and a lot of industry stuff there, and I thought, mines. Yeah, that could work. And I did some prototyping, just porting infantry from one side to another, and I think it felt really good. And then I immediately had like immediate ideas of, and I could then do this and maybe this, and stuff just popped into my head. And then I just designed the whole campaign around those mine shafts. And in the end, I had these traps where there is some artillery behind a mountain, and you have to destroy them, and to get to them you have to get through those mineshafts. And I think it in the end came really out really well. So yeah, I really do love this aspect that you just have one idea and then spin a whole campaign and story, and you have combat around it, and in the end it's a 3-mission campaign that feels really, really good.
Yeah, okay, I was absolutely not paying attention to anything you said.
I'm not
right
talking
now.
To you, I'm talking to our fans. Yeah.
Okay, that's good. Yeah, eat this.
Oh, what did you do?
Basically, the same duties in your turn.
So you just copied me.
Huh? Yes, of course. That's how you learn. You copy stuff.
You learn good, young apprentice.
Oh.
This little infantry thing with this one sliver of health.
Yeah.
Why did I design random damage? Why did I do it?
Just for this moment.
Yeah, everything came down to this moment.
It came all up to this moment now.
Yeah. So, I was like, yeah, I moved my whole army up there, and then, there's airstrike, bam.
Yeah.
So yeah, airstrikes are
but
not for my tactics. I use the big pack tactics.
So you're doing something like a death ball.
Yeah.
You just mash all your units together and then go through it.
It was not something that I captured.
Ah, of course not. Yeah. I try to concentrate on the sound of every unit and every action you do to get a feel of what you are doing in your turn. But actually, I have no idea.
I mean, we all know the sounds, but it's if you just hear the sounds, like, what was
that again?
The
only thing that pops in my head is like, okay, something's happening. Definitely something's happening.
So, this. Here.
Something I would never expect. You surrender?
It's actually the Spanish Inquisition. Props if you get the reference. really bait you. Master pushing.
Try to bait me?
Yeah.
You can't bait me. I'm unbaitable. Retreating. Coward. Oh, okay. Okay, yeah. Recovering. Yes. Ah, there's a commander.
No, that's not a commander. It's just an illusion.
Yeah. Yeah, for the guys who don't know this, but there are some special units in this game called the leader units, and if they die, one player has lost the game.
Yeah. So it's just destroy the enemy commander and you win.
Yes.
Which I totally forgot.
Okay.
You're taking awfully long for your time.
Yeah, I know. And I'm just spending a lot of gold.
I mean, we had 6,000 at the beginning, so that's a lot of gold.
Yeah.
I don't like the sound of falling bombs.
Well, get used to it. Okay.
You bought too many bombs. Should have like a timer in there.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe this could be the idea for a cool feature.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that was so cheesy.
The one thing that really, I could say, I had fun with was when we came up with the design of the commanders.
Yeah.
Or we just had it on paper and thought, yeah, maybe we could add some commanders and they can maybe do stuff like at the beginning we planned that they can buy units, which we then scrapped out later on because it didn't feel really good. And I think the day after we designed the leader stuff and presented it to the team and everyone, it was just one guy on Facebook just posted, hey, how about you implement commanders? And I was like, no. Now it looks like we copied his
yes. idea. We are fake. Yeah. We're actually fake. Yeah.
Oh. We're actually creative.
Okay, I might be too greedy on this, but actually...
Greed is always good. Yeah. Especially when I try to lure you into a trap.
Okay.
How much stuff can you do?
Yeah, a lot of units and a lot of action points. So. And a lot of gold. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you bombed probably half of my units away. It's like, another airstrike, and another airstrike. And you get an airstrike.
And you get an airstrike.
Everyone should have fought more anti-air, I guess. Yeah, everything down. It's always a spoiler of the heart which is wobbling, you already know this guy's.
Yeah.
This is like 10,000 gold that I lost. At least it feels like that. We should have picked the map without planes.
Without planes? Yeah, maybe. Because the planes have such a big movement range.
Yeah.
It's just too easy to get the vision and then set some airstrikes.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, we expanded on the idea of planes in the game, because in the previous games you had always like two planes, maybe three. And in this game we said, like, yeah, why not go more into the plane stuff?
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, we have now five planes, so we can do a lot more with the planes. But this also adds the problem that it completely goes against my strategy.
Yeah. everything has its downside.
Yeah.
And you actually always have to think about how the user could break your game.
Yeah. That's always on the one side. I have this really cool. I have this really cool idea about a feature that could work in the game, and then we test it, and it does work basically.
Yeah, and
but
it feels good.
Yeah, and it feels good, but you can't exploit it.
Yeah.
And they're like, no, but I don't want to change it. I mean, we had a lot of features and stuff during all the four games that we scrapped out at the end. Like one was, as I said in the beginning, that the leader can buy stuff.
Mm.
But then it was just, why do we then have paratroopers in there? Because we then have basically tank paratroopers.
Yeah.
And it was just weird to have that. Another thing that we planned was that the engineer can do some more stuff, which I don't want to spoil or anything. But the problem with that was then the engineer had like, hey, more buttons and more buttons. And the engineer is already, I think, overloaded with buttons.
Mm.
So we decided against that. And in Western, at the beginning, the bridges were capturable more easily. Like, you don't have to, or at the beginning, you didn't have to put your units up there to block the capture. But no, it was harder to capture, I mean, because you just had to have your units around the bridge.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just too easy to defend, because you could basically put your units outside of firing range if it's a three-tile bridge.
Yeah,
and that's the
put
feature.
It there
that,
and
that's the feature that was like exploited a lot when
yeah.
we tested.
Yeah.
So yeah, we scrapped that out completely.
Yeah.
And now I have to think how I myself on the goddamn planes.
But I also think sometimes you just have to go with a system that might not be perfect, because no system is actually perfect.
Yeah.
And you just have to think about, okay, is it worth to risk this? And is it that exploitable that it really breaks the whole game, or is it just something that the user could take advantage of, but not in the terms of, I don't know, getting infinite gold or something like that?
RNGesus really loves you, man.
Random Jesus.
Yeah.
Yes. You do that.
Yeah, well, but I interrupted you.
No, I already lost my thought. Thanks for that.
Master of distraction.
Yeah. It's like, because I'm really nervous right now, and I'm just trying to talk about something that's, I'm just talking the first thing that comes up into my mind. And if I get interrupted, for example, like because of a turn or because of you talking, then I completely lost my thought and everything is gone and I have to start again.
Poor
Jen.
And I just noticed I did again a big ball for your bombers.
Mm-hmm.
I really love my balls.
Yeah, but I think I already used the airstrike twice, so the next shot cost like 2,000 gold or something like that.
Yeah.
And I don't have that much gold left, I think.
Yeah. There was another thing in the design thing when we decided we have global abilities in the game. It's like, okay, we have global abilities, which is cool, and we have like immediately like 10 different abilities. And then we, no, that's too much, we'd have to cut it down. And the airstrike was the one that we had at the very beginning and we knew that we want to have definitely in the game. But to balance that out was really hard because... But the thing was, we had the airstrike in the game and at the beginning it costed around as much as it did now. I think it was like 400 at the beginning, but it didn't multiply.
Yeah.
And the first thing that the tester did was like, okay, I move one thing here, then I see the objective here, and I just airstrike, and it was way too effective. So I was the guy that spoiled the fun for testing and said like, okay, every time you use it, you have to use more. And at the beginning, it was just a little bit more, but then it was still too powerful. And now we decided we just double it. And a while ago, we kind of noticed that it might be a little bit too much if we doubled it too hard, so we now kept the stuff. It's a spoiler, actually. I think it's not released yet. But in the next update, the airstrike amount is capped at 2,000.
Yeah.
So that you maybe still want to use the, those 2,000. I mean, 2,000 is a lot, but if you can kill a lot of enemies with it, it might be worth it.
Yeah, for example, like, when I used it twice now, I killed a lot of units.
Yeah.
And I think it was worth it.
I mean, if you kill my leader at the end, it's probably...
Yeah, and this was actually... I was really angry that I couldn't finish your leader off in the last turn.
I saw the angry flamethrower that came at the end.
But no, it was too weak. Maybe I should have chose the anti-tank.
Probably more effective at the same. But also the German leader is more like the anti-infantry vehicle, so it's good against any infantry stuff. So.
Yeah, that's true.
That was also a challenge. You just have two different leader units. I mean, you have the leader tank as allies, and I have the leader car, basically, as Axis.
Yeah.
And when we did the missions, we tried to balance it out, because a car is not as tanky as a tank, which the name suggests. But I still wanted to have it not like be too short from anything, so yeah. It was fun at the beginning when I moved my tank forward, because the king has to move, you know.
Yeah.
That's my war doctrine, the king has to move. And then I moved with my king around, and then the AI just came
on. Runs.
So much references.
Yes. And probably no one will get this.
Let's see if I live another turn to find your leader. I mean, I saw him at the beginning.
Never find it. Never. So good.
There's also it's more like a desert map there, but there's no possibility to just camouflage. You don't see me anymore.
Yeah, that's true. Okay. So.
Should have chosen it. I totally blame it on the map. It's not my fault.
Maybe.
I cannot make mistakes. I made this game.
You are the creator. We only played 5 turns now.
Only 5?
Yes.
Feels like a lot more.
Yeah,
very
like
action heavy turns. Well, you don't go into my trap? Come on. There's so much
yes,
stuff.
Yes, because it was so obvious, your trap, that I just thought, no, this is, no, I won't fall for this. I'm doing the exact opposite thing of what you would think I would do. Wouldn't think I do? I know.
Grandma. More good for me. So let's see, how do I turn this around? I guess, so I need you to do stuff.
I don't like that you just sound that happy right now while doing your turn.
Yeah.
It feels like you have the upper hand now. Or you think you have the upper hand.
Yeah. What you don't know, I just tap a unit and tap another one just to create the illusion.
Yeah.
That's the advanced mind game. Right?
You're pretty good at this. Because it works. Psycho.
It will be really, really nice. Or it would be really, really nice if you have in the replay all the movement that the enemy made, and you just hear like moving in the fog, and like.
Yeah. And in reality, you are just tapping.
There's another funny story that I can tell you.
Yeah.
At the beginning, we had in Western, when we started with Western. I mean, you can as engineer, you can place a mine and disarm it, place it again and disarm it, place it again, disarm it, and do the same stuff with barricades.
Yeah.
And you could technically create an infinite replay for your opponent. we were doing this, and in the replay, I just do, and I give it to my partner at that point, and he was like, "What did you do? Why is this replay taking so long?" Yeah, and I was completely trolling at that point.
Yeah.
And I mean, I think it's still possible to do that. I give you bad ideas, I think.
Yeah. Oh no, my flamethrower guy is dying.
Yeah.
But he tried so hard.
He's angry, yeah.
Oh, he died for nothing. Can you do this to him?
Never let yourself be influenced by the dark side. Rage is bad.
Okay. I have to think what I could do.
I think we really do appreciate is user feedback. I mean, we appreciate it very much because it helps me to get just an outside perspective. Because if we are just doing stuff, you kind of get feature blind and think, yeah, my features are perfect and everything. And then you realize if you get an outside perspective, it's maybe not so perfect as you thought it would be. So it really helps if you guys just say, hey, this feature doesn't feel good, or hey, it would be nice to have this kind of game or this kind of feature. It helps me to just focus on the right stuff. So I really appreciate everything that you write to us. Is it either through support or in the store feedback on the ratings and stuff, or even, I don't know, comment on our Facebook page. It really helps a lot. And I definitely read every, I mean, maybe not every store description, but I get every email, I get every Facebook page comment. So I can definitely work your feedback in there. So just keep the stuff coming. William, turn.
Yes. I will, sooner or later.
More later.
Maybe
than
later. Yes. Okay. Oh, I just accidentally pressed the play.
No replay? What?
Yeah.
Can you do that? It's just like us turtling, I turtle at my base, you turtle at your base.
Yeah.
And then we just wait for each other. Interesting, man.
This might be not the right strategy for this game.
Strategy?
Yes.
Waiting.
Waiting could actually be a strategy.
What do you think of the charge feature?
Charge feature?
Yeah.
I think it's how do you say it? A double-sided sword, because on the one hand it's pretty powerful because you can just add two additional tiles to your movement range. On the other side, the charge costs a lot of fuel, and additionally to this, if you charge, you actually might have this feeling that, I will go another step forward. Charge costs a lot of fuel, and you might get the feeling that you want to pressure even more, and so you will maybe put yourself into a bad situation because you just storm into the enemies and you don't even see them, but you have already used all of your movement points, so in the next turn the enemy will just crush you, and this, I think, is the danger behind this feature.
Yeah. I mean, we worked a lot on charge.
27.
I think the first idea came when we looked more into, I mean, it was at the time that Devils and Demons came out, and it was more like Dungeons and Dragons themed game, and how could we put some D&D features in there? And in D&D you have the possibility to just move twice but not attack anymore.
Yeah.
And it was the additional idea that I have. You can just move twice but then can't attack anymore. But this would have just caused way more trouble, because if you can technically move like 20 tiles with a fast unit, you can, if you have a street, just move from one side to the other and capture a building.
Yeah.
And it was kinda hard. So we reduced the stuff a little bit, and and from the two times moving, we just made move two tiles further.
Yeah.
And I think, yeah, in the end it was like the better decision to do that, because
yeah,
if you do have this basically two action kind of thing, then, I mean, this also creates a lot of possibilities, like with the mortar stuff with the transform, it kind of is already that two action thing. You can either transform and move or transform and attack. But I didn't want to expand too much into it because it gets also really complicated. And we kind of are a core game on mobile, but also try to keep it more casual and accessible for everyone.
Mm.
And if you notice, we don't show a lot of text there, just more icons and bars to just give you a general direction, but not everything. So every statistic fan out there will probably be a little bit disappointed with the game. But for just
damn it,
casual user
again, I pressed play already.
For the casual user, I think
Sorry.
It's easier that way. And now I have a real problem.
I bet you are just saying this to make me feel safe, but actually you have like a murderer behind the fog of war.
but you don't know. You mean you always see like the top half of the stuff when you accidentally press again, and then the bottom half is like the whole army just waiting for you.
This is what I'm afraid of.
Honestly, when I thought this morning that we will do this, and just thought, okay, what could I do there? I just thought. My first thought was, I just have to capture your building and then you can't do anything. So I expanded my strategy on capturing just your building, and then, oh, but there are the commander, and I have to kill the commander to get the win and not the base. And this
but
just,
it's generally more easy to kill the commander because he's on the field.
Yeah, but
and every building is like on the other side of the map.
Yeah, I know. But I remember I was doing some Frozen Front multiplayer there, and we had a big battle going on. Like, everyone had like 5 big tanks because we were both very, very rich at, or at least I was very rich at the game at this point, and apparently my opponent too. So we just spammed heavy tanks, and in the end, he just destroyed my depot. And I was like, man, I can't do anything anymore. And now
well,
I lose.
That was unexpected.
And that in the end caused me to lose the game. So I was immediately then strategizing, and I just destroy your depot and you can't do anything.
Yeah.
But then, oh, but there's the commander, and I have to destroy the commander to just stop you from doing anything. Yeah. Now I have to think how to find your commander.
Good luck.
Oh, probably just move them at the edge of the map, like
maybe.
Coward strategy.
Or maybe he's just somewhere in the middle of the map camouflaged.
that would be the worst. I need to go. Let me destroy something.
Yeah, I was actually quite afraid of the map because there were so many trenches in there, but actually up until this moment, we barely used advantage of them.
Yeah, we're just
storming forward. And this is not how you win a war, actually, I guess. I think so. I have no idea.
Probably not. I mean, it's just us throwing money at each other.
Yeah.
Like, die, die.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, no.
Yeah. So we did so much design effort with those damn trenches, and then we just don't use them.
Yeah, that's actually... That's true. Should improve this.
Yeah. I mean, the trenches were paid to implement at the beginning, because we had the idea, hey, maybe you can build your trenches.
Yeah.
And this was like, but what if I just then build trenches around my depot and
then
you get captured anymore?
Exactly.
So we had to put like specific spots on the map that you could build it. Then it's hard to discuss or to show the user, hey, here, build your stuff, not there.
Yeah.
And in the end, it all just came out too complicated, and we scrapped the idea of having buildable trenches and moved it to the idea of having... The first idea was to have actually some kind of bunker thing, that the trench acts as a unit, like the bunker, and you go in anywhere and just move along in the trench and move out somewhere else, and you can actually...
Yeah, was your leader for a split second.
Not so sneaky at that
point. Okay, so let's see. Bam. Okay, actually...
I think the end result of the trenches is, as we have it now, it's hard to get into because you have this +2 movement to get into them, but then get this huge defensive boost. And I think
better
it turned out
better.
There's the knife.
I just know it. But okay, I will. I knew it! Okay, okay.
No one expects the second mine.
Yeah. That was on top of the other mine. Yeah.
But don't worry, there won't be a third one there.
Oh, of course not.
I'm not that evil.
Okay, okay.
Lots of plate noise again.
Yeah.
I don't like
plate. Yeah, but you actually also have an entire unit over there.
Yes, one.
Okay, no. Oh my god, I just...
What did you do?
Oh my god. I just thought, okay, maybe I could now do this turn, and then in the exact moment I thought, no, there's a mine over there, don't move there, and then my finger goes like, no, it's too late, brain. It's just too late.
I knew there was a mine.
Man.
I love mine.
When you see the replay, you will get why I...
It's just... I love mines for that exact feeling.
Again, I
press play. Especially because you can't attack after it, so it's even more... Nah.
Yeah.
So what did you do?
This was like the dumbest turn I could possibly do.
Ah, it was the anti-tank infantry? No, it was another one, right? Yeah, this one. Oh, it was a supply truck! Ah! Would be a shame if it died there.
Yes!
That's where a supply truck has to be, at the very front, to give me supplies in gold.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Damn it, fingers. Why are you so quick? Or maybe it's the brain's problem that it's too slow.
Or the critical combination of both.
Yeah. Probably.
I hope this is working. I don't even know where I'm going.
Yeah, and you captured something again. What is it? Any more supply crates? Ah, yes. I think there was one additional in the south. Okay. I actually have no idea if this is somehow entertaining for you guys, but actually I'm having a lot of fun right now.
Yeah, me too. I was like, how fun can it be to play multiplayer and then you just tap into mine after mine after mine?
To think about the next turn. Yeah,
think as hard as you can.
Yeah.
I think about how the turn is around.
Okay, let's see.
Let's see how much mines you find again. Yeah.
Oh no! Oh boy!
Surprisingly, your supply truck is gone now.
Yeah, oh.
And I also did this move where I captured your stuff back there and I was like, why did I do that? Because I cannot really do anything from back there to my depot on the other side, so. Very short term memory, like, oh, depot captured.
Don't like what I see. Okay, but now I know on this field there is no mine.
Every move you now know there's no mine there.
Yes.
There's no mine. Should have implemented a mini game with the engineer, just the minesweeper. Like, when you press somewhere, you see how much mines are around there. I mean, at the moment we're working on Deadly Desert updates, so if you're dying for an update, I can tell you it will come soon. And it will be stormy, maybe?
Yes.
Yeah. quite sturdy. So expect action in the new campaign that will come. Yeah. Made by me, so if you want to praise me, then do
give
me
credits.
Give credits all to me. And if you have something to blame, it's his fault. Everything is his fault.
Well, but they don't know all my email address. I hope so, at least.
It's always the adrenaline. Is there a mine? Is there a mine?
So no. That's it.
I think this is how I lose my lead position.
Yeah.
So how did you die? How did you kill my leader?
I just had my death ball there and stormed right through the door. Because then I knew. Okay, I saw in the replay that you moved your leader car a bit more forward, so it could be in the range of my units. And I thought, okay, maybe he just moved forward and then turned back, because this would be the smartest move to do. And then I checked with one of my infantries to look, okay, is there the leader still? Yeah. And then, oh my god, there's the leader! Now go, go!
Yeah, I think you outplayed me there. I think I lost the game when I was in the northern part of the map and you just put your two airstrikes and your bomber there and I lose like 5 units. And the fun thing was, I had this idea in the bottom that I wanted to do stuff, but then I didn't have enough gold.
Yeah.
And but I can't tell him I don't have gold anymore.
Really? You actually spent your gold?
I had no gold left at the end.
Okay,
because
what?
Yeah, I did a lot on the mine stuff. I put some units around the southern part again because I moved the big part on the north and some on the south.
Yeah,
and
you thought I would go for the middle. So you could basically attack me from both sides.
Yeah, I mean, I was hoping that you maybe discover the big thing on the top.
Yeah.
And then I could fall into your back with the other stuff. I mean, I didn't have much stuff at the bottom, but it was just some moving there, and I saw you killing me top, so I moved stuff back top.
Yeah.
And I just completely miscalculated there, I guess.
I think the most important turn for me was at the beginning, because I used my planes to get more vision on the field, so I would knew exactly, okay, there is the army, so there I would put
my ignored
best
my
plug.
Planes. I should have used the planes more. You got me there.
It's actually an advantage because there were no anti-air units in the start composition.
Yeah.
So you could just use your planes without the fear of getting them shoot down.
Yeah, and in the end when you put your two planes over the trenches, I was like, yeah, I can shoot them down now.
Yeah.
I only have one anti-air left. And then I wanted to move it back to the depot to supply because it didn't have ammunition in there.
Yeah.
And then I was one move short and then it ran out of fuel. And then it reached the depot. And that's when I tapped furiously at the thing because I couldn't charge it because I didn't have any fuel left, and I was like, I can't resupply it, I don't have enough gold to resupply. And I was like, no, I can't buy new ones, I can't supply it. That's the moment where I just defeated. Yeah, but I captured your depot like
that's
too.
True.
Yeah.
And this whole game only took 10 turns. Wow.
Yeah.
About 10 turns.
Long 10 turns.
Yes.
Feels like a whole day. So yeah, guys, if you have any comments on my humiliating defeat, then just flame me in the comments.
Yes.
Tell me how bad of a game designer I am. And also, if you have suggestions, maybe you want to see our coders next time battle against each other, or the loser battle between me and Jan maybe.
Ooh.
Would also be a nice one.
Yes.
Or we choose the king of the game between Mr. Johnny and our marketing guy Titian. Just let us know. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and also send us some feedback through Facebook or Instagram or whatever else stuff we have. It's always appreciated. We read everything that you send us. So thanks a lot.
Yeah, thanks for watching.
Bye, guys.
Bye.